Hi everyone, thanks so much for watching my YouTube video. In this video I will show you how to paint very easily this fluffy calico mixed tubby cat. It's really easy and it takes probably half an hour. You will need only a good watercolor paper. I used Arch 14 by 20 inches cold press on a block, and you need few watercolor brushes and at least a lamp black and a transparent orange watercolor. And I used this Sharpie pen for the whiskers, and I needed some masking fluid with the application tool and some water ball, and I think that's it. But you will see during the video what I'm using, but I think I told everything. And this is the photo which I used as a reference. I went a little bit more bright colors, but basically I used the outline of this cat. And after that it was outlining, masking, and then painting. So as you can see, my outline is very simple. I'm not going into too much details there. Just the outline, a little bit the tail, and some details on a face. Why it is important on a face? It's because you need to know where you put the masking fluid. So that regard, the ear, the eye, and the whiskers, where I use masking fluid, and the nose. If you use the masking fluid, it will be very, very exact. So it's defining, it will stay as it is if you use masking fluid. So that regard, the head should be kind of precise, or you will stuck with it probably if you use masking fluid. So I'm just using a neutral gray watercolor pencil. This will disappear when I wet the paper. This is a wet on wet technique. I usually use that for cat, not always. So when you paint, you will have very faint mark of the outline, but your masking fluid marks will be there. The masking fluid is only useful if you wait until it's dry. So be very careful on that. Don't try to paint when it's wet. It will destroy your pricey watercolor brushes most probably. So make sure you not start to wet your paper when your masking fluid is still wet. So you can see my masking fluid. I kind of shake it up a little bit because it's, when it's sitting, it's tend to separate. And I use this Asian style reed stick to apply it. There are several tools on the market for masking fluid application. I only use sticks and the reed stick, so I can't really talk about it, but I'm quite happy with the result of these tools. And when you're done, just wait a generous 20 minutes or longer if you need to, until it's dry. So as you can see, I draw the ear, the whisker, and the eye. And the nose. Masking fluid easy to correct, so if you're unhappy, just wait until it's dry. You can rub it off with your hand. and don't start to paint until you're sure you like the masking fluid, because after you paint over it, it will be very defining on your painting. Later it will be much harder to change. So if you need to correct, correct before you start to paint. So when it's dry, just remove it and do it again and wait again for drying. So see you back when it's dry. So I am back, mine is dry. I use a spray bottle and a thick Mottler brush to wet my paper. You can go with the Mottler brush alone or a big brush. It will be much harder if you don't have anything like bigger flat brush, but it's not impossible, but it's important to wet the paper entirely. And then equalize the wetness with the brush so you don't have drops or puddles. It's pretty bad wet, but not dripping. That's the trick. As I said, this is a very, very easy painting. I think everybody can do it. It's also short. The only important material, I think, is to work on watercolor paper. If you don't have artist quality paint, that's fine. I'm using Horadam and Danielle Smith. Horadam transparent orange and lamp black from Danielle Smith. So you can see I'm using a flat brush, but you can do this with a round brush too. It's called mine called Oval Wash, but any bigger brush is fine if it's a watercolor brush, so I don't think that's a big deal. You can see I'm not thinking too much. It's you need to be brave. The whole effect is coming from the watercolor behavior. So as the orange and the black color melt to each other, and on the edges it's fur out on a wet surface, that's what gave you the fluffy appearance of a cat. If you're interested to paint more like this, I have several Skillshare tutorials, many of them cat, much harder than this one. So then you can sign up for free for Skillshare. Please use my referral link, which I place below. But be aware that after, depending on the current promotion, Skillshare give you 1 week, sometimes 2 weeks, or maybe even more, a free trial period. And if you don't like, just make sure you not forget to sign off. But if you do it right, you can try it free for a few weeks or 1 week at least. So you can decide if you want to stay there. So that regard, it's risk-free. If you want to help me, please watch my YouTube videos all the way and share it. That will help me to reach the amount of subscription and watch hour to get monetized, which I really would like. So please watch all the way. Yeah, I hope you also try to paint, so it's not just watching, but it's also useful for you. I think it's really very easy, so you can see it's really easy. So I think you can do it. And if you want to buy original from me, I sell on Etsy and also on Saatchi Art. And also check out my other videos on YouTube. And as I said, please watch all the way. So it helped me to reach the required amount of watch time and subscription if you also share it. So you can see I'm working pretty fast because a watercolor dries. And You don't want to reach that point if you want this furring out effect of the watercolor paint. So you need to work fast. And if you work on a surface which is dry, it will behave very different. So if you want this fluffy furring out effect, work fast like me. I suggest to work last on a face, because there you need more precise little details. For that, use smaller brushes and do it when it's drier. Otherwise, for example, the ear will flow away and stuff like that. So the face is the last thing, especially the details on the face, because that you want to paint when it's a little bit drier. So you can see I almost done. Actually, the longer time will be the when I paint the details on the end. That also require absolutely to dry first the paper after you're done with the painting. So make sure you dry it and then come back. So when it's dry, it takes half a day to a day or overnight. When you are back and your painting is completely dry, you can use your clean hand, make sure it's not creamy or oily, and you can rub off with your finger the masking fluid, and that's when we will do the details, so the next part. So as you can see, you still cannot see some details right now. You can see I'm using a pretty sharp thinner brush. It's not a very thin brush, but it has a good tip. I'm adding some stripes and some characteristic lines on the face. Also, if you need to wipe, use kitchen paper towel. If something flowing too much and you need to interfere, kitchen paper towel is a good, easy thing to reach. And if it's not coming off easily, you can use clean brush and clean water to loosen it up and then wipe it off with a paper towel. So that's what I did on the edge of the face when it furred out a little bit too much. This is how you can correct. And I also did with the ear, because the ear a little bit flow too much. So make sure if you need to remove something, you do it right now, because as soon as it's dry, it's much harder, and also most cases it's impossible when it's dry to remove entirely. You can maybe lighten up, but no, not removing. So try to remove things now if you need to. So I'm almost finished before I let it dry. For the removal of the masking fluid. So make sure you finish it up as you want. If you need more time, continue a little bit longer, but I'm finishing up right now for this first round, and see you back when your paint or painting is completely dry. So mine is completely dry now. As you can see, I use my finger to rub off the masking fluid. I just leave a little bit on the where the whisker is, because I will work on a face and I want the whisker stays a little bit whiter, but honestly not much color around the whiskers, so it's kind of not that important. On the end, I decide to use Sharpie for the whiskers because there is no background color which would highlight the white whiskers. So as you can see, I'm again using a sharper brush. I draw the eye. And the nose with a pretty dense black paint, so it's not flowing at all, it's pretty dense, but it's still a watercolor, so it's not as it's coming out from a tube, it's leakier than that. But make sure your brush is not super wet, you don't want big thick drops or stuff like that. And I add a little brownish color into the nose. If it's too dark or you don't like the color, wipe it off and you can add later a new color or now. I like to a little bit overpaint the white of the masking fluid, especially on the ear, because it's not that white and it's just look too artificial. So I usually just add some colors to it. It still will shine through, so it still give definition, it still give that drawing around the ear and wherever it's needed, but I don't like to keep it just that bright white. So I'm just adding some details, mostly only on the face and a little bit on that white area, like the chin and the chest area, to have some definition there too. Also, I draw a little bit the mouth. So you can see I'm using a dirty brush color to put some shading on it, so you can see where is the edge of the cat around the chest area. I use my reed stick to I dip it in a black paint a little bit, but just very lightly, and I use for the mouth to draw it. I just want the mouth very light, so you can see where is it, but not too strong. I draw a little bit the tubby pattern. But I lighten it up a little bit. So the danger when you paint now, those will be very sharp because the background is not wet anymore. So this is how I avoid to make too sharp labels. Either you pre-wet the area so you get a little flowiness again, or you can just use your paper towel, clean paper towel, and you can lighten it up so the edges are not as sharp or strong if you don't want that effect. So you can see I add a little dirty grayish color just below the head to show the structure there. There is a neck and a mouth area, so I wanted that to be visible. Again, be careful to make it too dark, so you can just lighten it up if you have to. And I'm honestly feeling like it's pretty much done. After than that, I will only need the drawing with the Sharpie pen, and I only use that for the whiskers. So my Sharpie pen is Faber-Castell called Pitt Artist Pen, size F or small. You can get a lot of sizes, but it's pretty small, pretty thin. So you can see I just draw a few whiskers. And when it's dry, I remove the rest of the masking fluid and sign, and it's done. So as you can see, I'm mainly done. I have to remove the rest of the masking fluid, but that's it. Maybe I have to wait a little bit to drying, but yeah, don't forget to do that. If you also have leftovers, masking fluid, mine later became ugly yellow, and after, I don't know, some time, I can't remove it. It just goes into the paper very deep. So I always very cautious about the masking fluid. So make sure it's completely removed. Again, I really hope you try it, or if not try it, at least watch it all the way. Please ask questions or comment below if you want to. Also, if you want to help me, as I said, one way to watch my YouTube videos all the way and subscribe, and also maybe suggest to friends. If you want to help me other way, you can sign up to Skillshare using my referral links, which is below. That give me some advantage, and for you it gives some time, at least a week or maybe even two, free trial period on Skillshare. And if you want to help me even more, I sell originals. I suggest Etsy under the name Bodorka, and I also sell originals on Saatchi Art. So if you want to help me, these are the ways you can do it, and I would be very thankful about it. And I really hope you enjoyed this video. I also hope you will try it to paint this cat. It's really designed to be very easy. I would like to here send a special thank you for Rachel at Rachel Studio on YouTube. I guess most of you come from her channel. And I also want to say thank you for watching this video, and I really hope to see you on other YouTube videos or on my Skillshare tutorials. So thank you again for watching. Please subscribe and see you next time. Bye.